Are you looking for your first tech job? Do you wonder if you need to start at entry level or if you could start at a more senior level with a higher paying salary? What if I told you there's no such thing as an entry level job, only entry level skills? And in this video, we're going to talk about what it takes to be entry level and what it takes to get a much higher paying job as your first job. My first job, for example, was a senior network engineer. 3 months later, I was a lead architect. Many of the people I've trained have gotten their first jobs as solutions architects, as enterprise architects, as senior engineers. And you too can get any job you want as long as you actually know what to do and how to do it. But we're going to talk about why there's no such thing as an entry level job. Let's talk real careers, big careers, and a lot of careers. A physician, for example. You know, this doesn't seem like an entry-level job, right? But a person goes to 7 years of school, and then they do their residency, which is part of their school, and poof, someone's a physician. They're a doctor. It's their first job. Lawyers. You know, that's not, you wouldn't think of that as an entry-level job. You'd think of maybe a legal assistant or this or that. But a lawyer is someone's first job. Why? Because lawyers go to law school and they learn all the right skills. Same thing with airplane pilots. They don't start as a flight attendant. They start their first job as a pilot. So there's no reason to do this in your career. We can apply those same lessons to tech. Your first tech job is not based upon you being entry level or not. It's based upon the skills you actually have. And I can give you numerous examples, and you can look at several of the testimonials on our website where someone's first job was a solution architect or an enterprise architect, jobs which most people think take 5 and 10 years to get to. But it's all about your skills. I can also, at the same time, give you examples of people that have spent 10 to 30 years, and they still haven't reached the same levels as some people have as their first job. So let's talk about what entry-level training means. Let's say someone is looking to get a junior tech job, and what do? They train for a junior tech job. They go out there and they get these junior certifications like an A+, a CompTIA Net Plus, a CompTIA Security Plus, and maybe an AWS Cloud Practitioner. And guess what? They've got 4 certifications, but they're all super junior. The reality is this person's going to have to work very hard to potentially get a help desk job or a junior cloud admin role, or maybe a SOC analyst role, and it's gonna take just as long, if not longer, to get these roles than it would to start in a more senior role. And people that will start in a more senior role will have a much higher salary and typically a faster career progression. But why is this? It's because those basic junior level, entry level skills really aren't enough for most employers. And it's not, I'm not saying they're easy to learn, but they're not meeting employers' needs. So they're gonna be hard jobs to get, and they're gonna be very low paying jobs. Now let's look at the difference someone that trains for to be a senior person as their first skill. Now, my first role was a senior engineer, and I got heavy duty training. And to skip that entry level, you need heavy duty training. So the person will need to go deep into the fundamentals, far deeper than they would ever get on a CompTIA A+ or Net Plus, and truthfully, far deeper than they would ever get on a CCNA. We're talking deep knowledge. Knowledge of how the technology works, knowledge of how it would be integrated together. So let's say for a cloud security architect, they learn the cloud and they learn security. And they understand how the technology works and how you would apply it together. Then instead of getting these basic junior certifications like a CompTIA A+ or Net Plus, this person goes out there and gets a CISSP, which is a big heavy-duty security certification that's desired by many employers, a CISM, and a CCSP, 3 deep, you know, professional level cloud security certifications or security certifications. And then maybe this person gets the AWS Solutions Architect Professional. Now, this person spends a good 500 to 1,000 hours getting the right training in giving presentation skills, training in sales skills, training in executive presence, training in vendor management, stakeholder management, you name it, they train it. And they practice every day. And maybe in the same amount of time somebody else got a junior level job or a help desk job, you've got your first cloud security architect job or potentially a senior security engineer job, because you've now trained for deep skills, the kind that can solve employer problems, and you can get lots of jobs you want. So there is no such thing as an entry level job. There's only entry level skills. So there are no rules. No one says you have to start in the mailroom and work your way up. If you want to start in the mailroom and work your way up, that's fine. If you want to start at help desk because you desire help desk, that's great. But don't think training in someone else's job is going to make you better at your job when you get there. It'll just make you better at someone else's job. So train to be an expert and you'll get a more senior role. So at the end of the day, how do you want to build your career? Let me know how you want to build your career in the comments section below. And if you want to learn something like how to become a cloud architect, how to become a security architect, how to be an AI architect, or how to become an enterprise architect, join us for one of our free webinars or download some of the free ebooks in the description of this video. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Please subscribe to our channel and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to help you in your technology career. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video.